Others do not realize that we are all heading for death. Those who do realize it will compose their quarrels. Experiences are preceded by mind, led by mind, and produced by mind. All things arise in dependence on conditions, and they cease when those conditions no longer hold. We tend to go about life as though a favorable outcome is most likely to happen if we have, rather than if we give. If we win, rather than if we understand. Very painful, very salutary to understand the effect we've had on someone else. Sometimes we need that. We need to hear how our actions have landed.
With your heart, contemplate the certainty that all your relations and all your wealth will be as nothing, like a deserted city. Everything is impermanent, so be detached. With your heart, contemplate the inevitability of death. When it comes, your home and possessions, your friends and famous colleagues will not accompany you. Realize absolute truth.
Actually, there is no fixed self. We like to think that if we're just rather vague and we don't do anything very much, that somehow nothing much will happen. There's no standing still in the spiritual life. If you're not moving forward, you're slipping backwards. Ourselves. We change others' experience of us. And we change our experience of the world. We're trying to change our being. We're trying to change our consciousness. We're trying to change our essence, our nature. There's a danger of thinking that we'll still be who we are, but we'll just understand things differently. The nature of change actually has to be very gradual. We have to prepare the foundations. Radical transformation, real transformations will arise, but we can't force them. But there comes a time when it just would be our nature to be compassionate and wise. Though we're changing from a narrow, tight, self-interested experience of the world to something that's broader, more flexible, more empathic. And at some point, as all of this drops, something shifts. Only make sense of things in terms of time and space, but actually they're just relative. It's the nature of human beings to have experience in a particular way, and part of our experience, the nature of our experience, is to have this wrong, deluded understanding of ourselves. in the world, we are sharing in the Bodhisattva ideal, and we're sharing in that responsibility that we and others have an effect in the world. So whatever our circumstances, we have enormous freedom. Over time, we can create a very different world for ourselves. Others do not realize that we are all heading for death. Those who do realize it will compose their quarrels.